or like a brownout or something, and I had to my computer restarted, so I had to, oh my god. Anyway, y'all know what that is. I have to start a new video. Yeah, I have a swim here. I have a good swim. Swim, that is. And I hope on my previous video, the recordings and audio is all there. I don't know. I'll have to check it later. So I have a swim chip here we can put on. So let's take care of that right there. Okay. Swim orientation is. Okay, so here we go. Let's just came back into the program and I just noticed that my microphone was muted, so muted throughout that whole conversation I was doing for an hour's worth of work. I was muted, I would have to, then I can't use any of these videos. Then managed to put a new SSD, 1 terabyte in my bench computer here because the spinner was starting to give me trouble. Last PLC. Want to make sure it's a swim. At the back mark swim. All right, all the PLCCs are on. Keep on going. We can put this one crystal on now, but or this oscillator, whatever you want to call it. I'll have to clean up that leg. Same thing with this one. This one. Okay, let's put this one on here. I'm gonna hold it with my finger and just put some flux on one pin. Put some solder on my tip. Secure just one pin for now. Then I can let go of and bring it open to the rest. Okay, that's on there. None of these other things I can put on yet. CPU socket, yeah, that's the next highest thing. Then come all the other sockets. All right, so we're gonna continue here. Now I'm gonna I was finding my volume kind of low, so let me see about here, maybe fixing up this gain a little bit. That any better, any better, any better? Yeah. Okay, well, put it there. Let's see. I have the CPU socket, so we're going to throw that on here and flip it over, and now I can rest it there. Now I'm just gonna solder one pin each corner. Then I can heat them back up and make sure it's pushed in good. There you see? Good thing I did that. Okay. So now that's pushed in good and we can come here now. Now I'm gonna try to zoom out a little bit. Trying to get a bigger surface area. Fireworks outside. Sometimes when I hear them, they scare me. I'm not expecting that bang. What if anyone doing a stream tonight? I may not be up very late tonight. I may go watch something on my iPad for a little bit. I'm tired. I've been getting up very early, like 4:30, 5 o'clock. But then again, I want to finish this board. CPU socket. Now is when coming a lot of pins to solder. Because when I start doing these sockets, oh my god. Okay. That socket on there. He did give me some sockets, but I don't like to use some of these. They're not, so I'm not gonna use them. This is the 25 pin. Yeah. I need only one of those. I don't know why he sent me so many of them. All right, let's get the sockets out. Oh. All right, I have the two for the video. Let me switch over to this camera so you can see. I need some four. I need two of those. That's these two. Okay, I need this ROM one, which is this one, video ROM. I have the two RAM, video RAM, and I think these are the ones. These two are the two for the Sony chips. And these ones are the ones. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I need for now. Okay. All right, let's start with some of these. Now, what I like to do is I like to put them in and bend some legs, and then, that sounds bad, but the reason why I like doing it that way is because then I can flip it over and just solder all of them in. One shot. Oh, I have a crystal there I can put on. Okay, let's see, one of these here, they go here. Okay, let's see where else I can put these other two in. These are for the filters or the resistor networks. I like putting them in sockets because a lot of times they fail on me. We have the two Sony chip ones. Before I do those two, I want to do the caps that are there. Because you see the caps right here next to the plastic. I mean, I guess I could put them in. I could go ahead and put them in the caps later. Yeah, I'll go ahead and secure them in. Video PAL system. Sockets are on the board, ready for soldering. Did I bend that leg out? No. There we go. Alright, the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to solder in this one crystal here quick, because I don't want to lose it. It's been rolling around the desk here. Okay, so now we got a lot of sockets to go solder, so let's start it. Right there, how's your phone? Oh. Okay. Your focus very good there. And we will start soldering these away. Alright, that one is in. This one here, I'm going to do opposite. I want to heat them up and push on it. And the other thing I want to do too, because this is a bigger chip, I want to straighten the legs that I bent back. Because then, should you ever have to remove it, easier. Be a lot easier to remove that chip, the socket. Heads are bent down. And that was a fun board to do, and I did that. If I didn't do all that SCSI testing, I would have that board done in 3 hours. That was a fun board. Okay. Here now. I'm gonna try to prep two in a row. Morning. Maybe back in the evening. Yeah, that was the opposite direction from what I could do the soldering iron. I did it that way. I might fix my friend's MacBook Air that I have tomorrow. I have a keyboard I need to install on that. Let's get these last two ones here. These are the two for the video RAM. I mean, I still got more sockets after this, but it's just these are the last two in this area. And again here too, I will straighten these up. That's my focus. My eyes are getting tired. My eyes are really getting tired. After these sockets, we'll do the caps. Okay, all right, we have some more over here now. These are the two for the Sony audio chips. Oh, let me push them before I Oh, good thing I did, because that one was pretty loose. Okay. Okay. Ones for the filters. I got three of those, and then I got one small little 4-1 on the other side. Sorry, I was sending out a message. Okay. More fireworks going off outside. Here, make me jump. I don't expect it because it's like quiet here in the neighborhood. All right, let's bend these back up. Yeah, I really just bend them just temporarily just to hold. All right, here we go. Okay, two more to go. One is a small little one here. Flush. Okay. That's all those sockets. Now come cap time. Okay. Can we do caps now? Yes. There's really not much left after this. Let's hope these are not the very big. They're good enough. I can use them. Okay. I need 10 of these. Seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay. Let me put down some flux on all these caps. All right, so we have them here. Let's go ahead and start soldering some of these down. Well, all of them down. I put 8 of them on the board right now because they're all in this area. Right now, I'm just soldering one down one side, and I'll flip it over and get the other side. A different cap goes at that spot that I left open. That's going to be a 10 microfarad. Okay, we're now gonna come and hit the other sides. Two up here in front. Let's get them done quick. Okay. Okay. Put some solder on here. Okay, now let's get that other one that we're missing. Right now, he sent me one of the axials, the 70. So this is the one that goes over here. One of the things I like to do is I like to put the solder from this side also. I mean, when I flip it over, I can go ahead and stand these two legs up because it's already secured. And there we go. Right now I need a 220 I have those here somewhere. I have a whole slew of them. Make sure I put that one correctly. I sent the board out to Canada and I had that crap backwards. I felt so bad, but it's funny. I mean, I tested it. It was fine. It worked. It never blew the cap or anything. Scott, my friend, in that chatting with. He's getting some machines ready to sell at Southwest. He's got a slew of machines this time that he's going to take. Mainly SE30 classics. Okay, so what's next? What do I need to put on next? All right, I can see about sockets. I think I have a 19-pin one here that I took off. Yeah, but this is one that's gonna go with rivets. Well, Jan, you're going to be lucky. Because I'm going to put a brand new 19-pin PCB DB on your board. Yes, I have them. I have a whole slew of these. I bought like 500 of them. Okay, so let's go ahead and solder these. We're getting down to the wire here. I don't have much left to put on this board. Now some view a little. the new one on the. Now both of these have the lock pins. Okay, now he did provide me all of the DINs. I really don't need all these on for me to test it, but just in case if I need TechStep, I want to be able to go right to it, not have any delays. But it's also nice just to get done. I mean, just. Okay, so the serial and, well, the printer and modem are in. Now I'm going to make sure about the keyboards, the ADBs. That one is good. Good. That's soldered them in. Okay, and I think I have an audio jack here too. I can put on. Hey, it fell out. Pin that's bent wrong. Not one of the bent wrong ones. I got too much. Now it's a problem. Okay. See where I'm at now. I got these. I don't want to put the two switches on yet. I got all these chips that I need to go in there, but we'll do that later. Right now, I think I want to get the ROM socket and the two RAM. I'll do the SG4 RAM in there. But before that, I have to run the restroom, and I'll be right back. All right, so ROM socket. Let's get this one in here. That's the midpoint there. I'm gonna put in all of the RAM. Let's go 2, 4. That's all I need for this thing. Getting down to the wire here. Down to the end. I do have the ferrite beads. The ferrite beads still to put on. Done. Now let's get 4 of these RAM in here. Got some pins here that are not in nice shape. I put that one aside. Too many pins that are bent. These two. You're gonna tack them now, then I'll push them up. It's 28, 30 pins. I did 2 on each. That's 28 for each. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Okay, let's get the last. Another one. Start using sign data. Hey, sorry, I'm not talking too much. I'm just trying to push this board through. I guess with that little brownout we had today, I need to get a UPS and put it on my computer. I do have a household generator that's on a transfer switch, but the board that it didn't turn on. Them sockets are in. This sucker needs to go on there. Pins are in bad. In there. Yay. Since I'm here too, might as well do these two switches now. Go ahead and just What are all these little things here? Quick, they're all in the same little corner. Okay, your connection. I'm gonna try this away. Smart. Okay, what else do I need to solder on? I don't think I have anything else to solder on right now. Right now it's time to put in some chips. So I do have this power adapter I need to solder in. So let's get that in. It's in. Let's go see about some of these chips now. This one is not a chip. This is just another choke. There. So that pin is just ground. Okay. Those are all in. These are the two Sony sound chips. See how those look. Okay, these two big ones are the RAM for the video. Okay, This is the RTC. Next five are the video PAL ones, which I gotta look on a sheet to see. I have these written down where they go. So this one is the 635. 635 goes UG6. UG6 is gonna be right here. Next one. This is 633. 633 goes UG7. Next one. 637. That's UE6. How could I happen grab 688? I grabbed them right in order. And the last one goes right here. Make sure, I gotta straighten up some legs here. I felt them crooked. Ooh. Now we're gonna get it in the socket. Okay, all those are in. Old board. I need to pop off. It's on right here. For you to pop out. There. Oh. Okay, CPU is in. Oh, what is missing now? Ferrite beads. I got a few more I need to take off. I've only got five of them off. So, let's go to the desk cam. Let's take these off quick. They're gonna be back here. It's 10 o'clock already? Wow. My bedtime chime came up. I want to get this done. I'm at the last item now. Before we can fire up. So, guess what? We're going to finish. All right, with the ferrite beads, I'm going to use paste. A lot easier. I'm gonna start off with this one here. You can see there's one. I got three right here. Three, and then I got one more right here. All right, let's get these on there first. Hot air. I have almost. See how that goes. Okay, that's five. So now I'm going to put up the other ones. One goes right here, R21. I got one loose one right here, and then all the other ones are in a row. Got four of them right here. Two, three, four. I have three of them right here. One, two, three, and one over here by itself. Okay, that's it. After this, it's memory and ROM time. sure, because I had problems last time with one of them. I'm just gonna Sam, it was this one that wasn't providing power to the SCSI. That one was not connected. Okay, folks. We are at the point of testing. So let's put away that, let's put away the solder. Well, let's wind it up. Boy, I haven't wound that up in such a long time. Let's move some of these bags out of the way. Alright, what do I need here? I need a blue SCSI. I want my Mac-o-meter, so if you do not have a Mac-o-meter, I would suggest you get onto our website. This is a KMAC creation. We designed and created this. Anyone else that has one out there has a copy. But that's alright. We all play nicely together. ROM. Pieces of blink RAM. Love the blink RAM because I can read the flashes to know what's happening. Okay. Let me get a speaker here. And are we going to have all good? 3, 2, 1. Nada. Get anything on the screen? No. want to re-verify some things here. Gonna verify. Verifying that I got all of these on the correct direction. Okay, let's. I'm gonna check my solder work. That all my solder work is good. Let's go look at this ADB. I'm gonna check these VS at the same time. So we're checking three of these at the same time. This I can pop out. Oh, the cover came off of that. And I'll see why I do these PLCs before I do the caps and that, because it makes getting. SCSI. Serial. Okay, all of those are on good. Not a chip soldered on bad, that's not getting. Okay, crystal is on good. Let me clean these for 1 second here. This is the things about problem solving. I may swap out those two crystals because they're not, I don't like using those barrels. Especially, I don't like using a crystal from an old. All right, 393. The only one I don't know if it's on the right way is the 166. I don't think it is because I think the lines are over here. I'm gonna take off this 166 and flip it around. I'm gonna put this straight back on with hot air. I need a bit more flow. And I want to do one thing quick here. I want to take some readings of these resistor packs. Those are good. Let's check these other ones here. 22. Yeah. Okay, so those are all good. I mean, I'm not worried about them. So it's something else. It's something else that's not letting it start up. Let's see if it could be that chip on backwards. I think what else it could be. See if I mis-soldered anything. Let's give it a shot again and see. I don't think that one chip would have caused a difference. Yes. I have blinking RAM. I have screen. Oh my God. Look at that. I have pointer. But I don't have audio. And I have I should get boot. Oh yeah, there's boot. Boot coming. It booting up. Wow. That one. That might be the jack. It's not the jack, it's my cable. My cable broke. Look at this. So let's grab the other speaker. Ta-da! Ta-da! Wow. There it goes. Something about that SCSI is still not fast enough, though. It's not something. I think maybe the board needs a good cleaning, though, too. I got flux all over the place. But there it is coming up. There it is coming up. So Jan, your board is alive. Four SIMs, RAM SIMs to put on, one PDS slot, a floppy connector, a SCSI connector, and the metal bar in the back. Control panel, let's go mouse first. I want to make it fast. Okay. Control panel, sound. And we can do the look at something nice and new that I have on my OBS. And that's my OBS. It's on the computer, on my OBS, quack, quack on the computer, simple beep. Oh, where's my EEP? Oh, my EEP is up here. So anyway, got some sounds on my sting coming up. So anyway, yeah, I have that. So let's shut this down. I want to do one more test. For this, I can practically disconnect everything here. Oh, I need power still. Keyboard though. My brain. The infamous TechStep. My go-to test tool that some people claim is no good because help with the machine knowing what is, because you have to have a working machine. Yes, granted, you have to have a working machine to a certain point, but it could be a lot of functionality not working, which I have proven with other tests that have saved me. So to me, this tech step is important. From what I hear, TechStep is available in some other ROMs too that right now it's not out there, but it will be soon. Anyway, okay, so turn on TechStep. We go into the SC30. On, terminate. It will be connecting. I should get a sad back on the screen. Once it connects, yep, there it is. This will say connection made. And let's go to logic test and let's do all. There we go. I apologize for some slow periods in this video. This one is 1 hour and 46 minutes. I don't know how long the other one is. Oh, I don't know if you heard my sounds in that thing because I don't have the audio capture. I only have it here on my speaker. Oh boy, I need to add it. Add audio output capture. Existing, this one, okay. So you should be able to hear that now then. Let's see. Okay, those are coming from my stream deck. So this is all logic tests pass. Swim fail. Oh no, I got some problem with this swim. I may have to replace it. Let's go test it again. Failed. All right, I'll have to, you see how good this is, even though the machine booted up and everything, but it's found that a chip is bad, that a swim is bad. So, well, let's test the other ones then and make sure. Okay. ADB. So the swim chip I thought was good because I had it marked good in my bag, in my box of goodies, and it turns out to be bad. So anyway, I'm going to turn this off. We're going to go to my lovely face because I'm going to call it a night. It is 10:36. We are at a good point with this board. The only thing I need to do is change the swim on it. We should be good. I need to finish the last few things on it. So anyway, folks, I'm going to call it a night. I'm tired. Been a long day. So anyway, y'all know where to find me here on KMac Vintage on YouTube. KMacVintage.com is my website. KMac Vintage on Twix, Twitter, or X. So might as well call it Twix. Yeah, go to my store there on my kmacvintage.com site. See all the nice products that we have: ROM, RAM, Macometer, Dash 20, Budget Dash 20 externals. The ROM SIM Programmer version 2, amazing device. So make sure that you take a look at that. There is a special going on right now for it. So anyway, like the video, do me a thumbs up, please. You can also support the channel by going to kmacvintage.com, and there is a donate option there that you can donate one time or do a monthly donation. Donations go to keep the channel running and keep my supplies coming, like wick and flux and solder and alcohol and flux cleaner and so forth. But anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. Y'all have a Merry Christmas that's coming up. I'm sure I'll have some more video tomorrow working on the same board because I want to get it done. So anyway, good night, everyone. Take care. Bye-bye.